Well, this is part two of our corn harvest. It's the same day. He had a little trouble with the combine shearing a bolt off, so we got that fixed. And now we're ready to go out and get some more wagons.
Thank you.
leave some corn out here, and then in the next few days I'm gonna come out and pick it. So hopefully you'll get to see a video of a number five picker working on some corn. Well, he's got corn on these two wagons, so we'll go empty them. Hopefully, he'll have the other two full by the time I come back. Nice and covered with corn flakes here. If you've never been around corn, that's the nice bonus that you get, is little dust flakes. I think the graphite paint has really helped these wagons. It pretty well empties all the way out now that the paint has gotten worn in a little bit. So we can watch this wagon empty and see how good it does. Well, he's about finished up. And I think we're down to the point where I'm just going to walk out here and get the other tractor, because everything should fit on the last two wagons. And you can see what happens if I walk out here. All my pals start to follow me around. I guess they figure any second I could give the order to empty that thing out into the pasture here and they could be in corn heaven. Red there, gonna check it out. Find some cob pieces that have been flung out here. And then of course everybody else has to come along too, so that's fine. Gives them something to do. There's probably really not much to do as a cow, so if this excites you, go for it. This is riveting footage, I'm sure, a fat man walking through a cornfield, so enjoy this. You probably don't get to see this just anywhere on YouTube. You can see this corner by the road gets really wet. That's why I told him he better cut across a little bit. That was actually planted a week later because it was wet. And I patched it in, tried to match up row for row. But anyway, still had to end up going crossways because it's too wet to go all the way to the end. You have to drive in and back out. That's the way I usually do it. It just seems like, for whatever reason, it's hard to get this corner dried up. I talked before about we used to have a whole bunch of hogs outside here, and that's what we usually did with the areas that were notoriously wet. We fenced them in and made a hog pen, like this random clump of trees here in the field. That entire woods out there was all full of hogs. And at the other end of the road down here, we had a big pen and a whole bunch behind the barn. And when people went to confinement hog houses, they kind of ruined that for us. So anyway, I've been working a little bit each year to try to get it level again and more dry. So I pretty well got that other field over there pretty good. There was a few places, if you remember, in the double crop beans where it didn't totally drain off, but otherwise it's a lot better than it was. So hopefully that's the name of the game every year, to improve it a little bit. Oh, fat man, a dog, and a 1655 coming this fall to your local CBS station. Riveting entertainment. I'd say he's done. He's headed this way, so good deal. We've got enough corn left to play with, and I got another guy that's texted me last night, and he wanted to come and get some ear corn next weekend, so we should be in pretty good shape. Like a wrap. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.